Hello, everyone. Welcome to Sagemaker Friday. This is a 15-minute webinar on Sagemaker geospatial capabilities. We are excited to have you here. This session is for data scientists who are looking to get started on geospatial machine learning, expert data scientists who are looking to accelerate the time to build, train, and deploy models using geospatial data, and product managers, GIS analysts, or executives looking to find inspiration on geospatial machine learning use cases. I'm Amit Modi, head of product for Sagemaker Geospatial Capabilities. In this session, we'll talk about what is geospatial data and how are customers leveraging geospatial data for machine learning use cases. Then we'll talk about what are the key challenges in geospatial machine learning workflow and how can Amazon Sagemaker help you overcome those challenges. And then we'll show you a demo of how a data scientist can help first responders manage response to a natural disaster and make life-saving decisions. Let's dive in. Geospatial data consists of satellite and aerial imagery and map data. Satellite and aerial imagery consists of visual and non-visual information. Visual information is very similar to the red, green, blue images captured from your iPhone, except these images are captured from satellite and aerial vehicles, and they capture information of Earth's surface. And non-visual information is the information of thermal emissions or infrared radiations. Customers today are using hundreds of terabytes of satellite and aerial imagery to extract meaningful information that is stored as map data, for example, building footprints, road networks. Map data also comes from devices and sensors around you to express the neighborhood. For example, point of interest data that you use multiple times a day to find a coffee shop, restaurant, or gym near you. Today, geospatial data is available everywhere. What percentage of data do you think in your organization has geospatial component attached to it? Type us in the chat. Based on the studies, we believe 60 to 80% of all data contains geospatial component. Geospatial data has become readily available in the last decade because of two changes in the industry. One, the prices to launch a satellite dropped from tens of millions of dollars to less than $1 million. And two, nearly every sensor in the market today is capable of emitting location data. With readily available geospatial data, customers today are using this data to make faster, smarter, and more informed decisions with a button click that otherwise would have taken weeks or months. For example, insurance companies are using this data to issue you an insurance quote remotely. Commodity traders are using satellite imagery to predict the yield of commodities so that they can better predict prices. And governments are using this data to inform policies for climate change and to hold other countries and companies accountable. City and state governments are using this data to identify areas for sustainable development. And agriculture companies are using satellite imagery to predict yield of the farm and to issue recommendations to farmers so that they can increase the yield of farm. They're also using the same data to help city and state governments manage food security. And retail companies are using this data to identify the next location for opening the store. Geospatial data is unlocking completely new and interesting use cases. We believe this is only the beginning of how organizations will be able to innovate faster and solve business problems. We can't wait to see what you will do with this technology. Although there are so many use cases, it is still challenging for the organizations to work with geospatial data. Let's tap into the geospatial machine workflow to understand why. A typical geospatial machine learning workflow has five steps. First, acquiring data is a slow process. Customers who want to access geospatial data need to build out connectors to read this data from open data sources or negotiate deals with third-party vendors to get access to data. This is just to access the data before you can even get started with machine learning workflow. And once you have access to this data, it often isn't enough. You need to transform or enrich this data so you can get it ready for machine learning. To transform and enrich this data, you need to invest in building out infrastructure that can process terabytes of data. For example, if you're working with satellite images, then you may want to remove clouds and restore the ground information, or just mask the clouds. And if you're working with GPS coordinates, then you want to augment the information of latitude and longitude with addresses or with road segment where these GPS coordinates were collected. And once you have this data, which is transformed and enriched, you need to build out high quality label data sets for machine learning. To build out a high quality label data set, you need to find a third party vendor who can create this data set for you. Each of these steps can take weeks before you can even train a model. And once you have trained a model, you can now start to make predictions and visualize these predictions. Now you want to share these predictions with other data scientists and non-data scientists in your team so that everybody can explore and analyze these predictions to make decisions. Even that requires infrastructure to share these predictions, which again can take a few weeks. All of this makes working with geospatial data time consuming and expensive. To solve some of these challenges, at reInvent, we've launched Sagemaker geospatial capabilities. These new capabilities make it easy for data scientists and machine learning engineers to build, train, and deploy models using geospatial data. Let's take a look at the key features of these geospatial capabilities. First, challenge that we talked about was getting access to geospatial data and building connectors to read this data. Now, Amazon SageMaker provides APIs that enable you to access data from open data sources, like Landsat and Sentinel-2, with just one API call. If you already have data sitting in Amazon's Simple Storage Service, which you acquired from a third-party provider, you can simply read that data into SageMaker if it comes from a provider that's supported by SageMaker, for example, Planet Labs. Without the need to build any integration, you can simply read Planet data from Amazon Simple Service Storage into SageMaker. And if you're using one of the managed operations that we provide to transform and enrich this data, then we make that data set available inside SageMaker, accessible and visible to every data scientist in the organization so that you can improve their productivity and reduce cost. To transform and enrich this data, you can simply migrate your code from existing notebooks into SageMaker because SageMaker notebooks now come pre-installed with open source geospatial libraries. This makes migration much easier. And if you want to start using managed operations provided by SageMaker, then we have introduced a concept of Earth observation jobs inside SageMaker. All you need to do is provide an area of interest, temporal dimension that you want to process, and the type of operation you want to run. And then we take care of taking this data, splitting it on a cluster, processing it, and stitching it back together and giving you the results. And if you're working with GPS coordinates, then you need to probably augment that with address information or the information of road segment where they were collected. You can kick off vector enrichment jobs to augment and bring all of this information. Now that you have transformed and enriched data, you can start to make predictions by leveraging the purpose-built models that come inside SageMaker for basic operations like cloud masking, cloud removal, land use, land classification. You can simply use one of the models that come inside SageMaker to make predictions. We understand that you may have domain-specific needs for a machine learning model. In that case, you can leverage SageMaker Ground Truth and SageMaker Ground Truth Plus to create a high-quality label data set that can be used for training a model. And if you already have a model that you're using to make predictions, then you can leverage. You can just bring your own model on SageMaker or your own container to start making predictions. Now that you have your model ready, you want to visualize these predictions. You can now visualize predictions inside an embedded map that comes pre-installed into the notebook. This interactive map allows you the capability to render millions of data points and share with other data scientists and non-data scientists so that everybody in the organization can explore and analyze the results. If there are other features that you would like to see in our roadmap, let us know. You can shoot me an email or leave some comments in the chat. Now, let's see how all of these features come together to bring an end-to-end experience to life. In this demo, we'll see how advancements in machine learning and readily available satellite imagery is not only helping us forecast natural disasters, but also manage our response to making life-saving decisions. We'll see how a data scientist can help first responders with relief efforts during a flood. Using the geospatial capabilities in Sagemaker, I can now predict dangerous road conditions caused by rising water levels. I can use these predictions to guide first responders to take optimal path, deliver aid, emergency supplies, or to evacuate people. Without Sagemaker, it can take a few days to get access to real-world data because data is scattered and hard to visualize, and it's even harder to train and deploy models with this data. In case of an emergency, I want to move as fast as I can because every minute counts. First, to build a model, I need to access geospatial data. This data is now readily available inside Sagemaker. Rather than spending time aggregating data from different sources, I can simply select the image source and show the affected area. In this case, Sentinel-2 from open source datasets. Now I can apply land use land classification model that comes pre-integrated with SageMaker to classify land as having water or no water. I can compare the images before and after the flood to see the water spread across the region and where it caused the most damage. These images help me understand the amount of impact that was caused by the flood. However, I still need to zoom in to see if the roads in the area exist to help first responders navigate safely. To zoom in, I add high-resolution satellite imagery from Planet Labs, one of the third-party providers supported in SageMaker. This visualization allows me to overlay roads on the map so that I can easily identify which roads are underwater and keep first responders up to date on the information. I can now start to make predictions using this data. With SageMaker, I don't have to spend weeks iterating on the best model. I can simply select road extraction model to make predictions. The model identifies roads that are still intact and not underwater. I can use this information to send directions to the first aid team. Using SageMaker visualization tool, I can view these predictions on an interactive map, so I have full visibility on what is happening on the ground. I can see green roads are still intact and accessible to first responders, while red roads are now submerged. I can also add point of interest data from Foursquare to see where the nearest hospital, medical facilities, and airports are. For example, here I can see that MRCM airfield on the left is surrounded with water, while the temporary helipad and international airport are still accessible. I can provide this information to the first responders so that they can deliver aid, emergency supplies, and evacuate people. To get started on SageMaker geospatial capabilities, simply scan the QR code and visit our website. If you're interested in learning more about SageMaker geospatial capabilities, register for an interactive and deep dive session with geospatial experts on March 31st. Link is in the chat. Thank you. If you have suggestions on the roadmap, on what you would like to see in our next demo, shoot me an email. Thank you.